Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this special episode of Algae Corner. I'm your host, Dr. West Bishop. Now, what we're going to cover today is a research update on Captain XTR. Now, specifically, what that means is we're going to look at some of these peer-reviewed studies, some of the scientific literature that's been published on Captain XTR, and just go through it a little bit at a time. And the key goal here is to help you understand how Captain XTR can be used in aquatic systems, how efficient and effective it can be in a wide array of algal species in a variety of sites. So to set up what we're going to do, we're just going to go through just one or two slides, show you some graphs, some images from this research, and step you through these individual experiments and give you that update on what Captain XTR can do. So first up, I want to talk about non-target species out there. So there's a lot of cool creatures in aquatic systems, Daphnia and fish and things that we don't want to harm, that we don't want to control. So this first research that we're going to cover is with Captain and Captain XTR, and it shows that, you know, first of all, it's innately less toxic than other products like copper sulfate. So Captain is a lot safer to these non-target species, these beneficial species in aquatic systems, than copper sulfate. And secondly, when we actually look at this in a realistic field exposure, when we're treating algae with Captain XTR, a lot of that product actually sorbs and sticks to that algae. So the more efficient and higher affinity we can have with this product sticking to the algae, the less that's out there, you know, posing risk to these non-target species. So again, very, very efficient product at controlling non-target species and much safer than other formulations at not harming those non-target species. All right, the next research update we want to give you, this next study was on flowing water. So a lot of irrigation canals out west, a lot of chemigation systems, or just these decorative waterfalls or water features. But, you know, flowing water can get a lot of nuisance types of algae in there that clog it up, and it's important to be able to use Captain XTR in those systems. So what this study looked at was this precision pulse application, just this slow pour of Captain XTR into the flowing water. And what we could do is track how far that copper is moving downstream and how much control we're getting of that nuisance algae, even in these flowing water scenarios. So Captain XTR is high efficiency, sticks to those algae, controls those algae, even with these short contact times. So you see here in these graphs that the Captain XTR, how far it can move downstream. Here's just a couple images of just 8 miles downstream. We can get significant control of nuisance types of algae, even in these flowing water scenarios. All right, next up, the next paper was looking at a concentration exposure time. So we looked at a very tough nuisance type of cyanobacteria called Lingbia. Some people call it black mad algae. It smells bad, it produces toxins, but real thick. It's spreading throughout the U.S. But we wanted to really, you know, look at Captain XTR and how efficient we can be with that formulation at controlling it, and at a specific field site with different environmental conditions and flows and biomass, you know, what concentration of Captain XTR over what exposure duration we need to get control. So here's just that CET diagram, and again, we can help you design that program to get efficient control of even these toughest nuisance, big, thick, black mats. All right, the next study is looking at comparing Captain XTR with different copper algicide formulations. So how does it match up? Is it better than these other formulations? Is it more effective? So we looked at that, and then we took it one step farther and asked, why? What makes Captain XTR different? And we could actually track that copper getting inside. So these first couple graphs here from this paper just showed that we're much more efficient at getting control, significantly better at getting control of some tough types of algae like Pithophora, that horsehair algae, and again that Lingbia, that black mat algae. So significantly better than other chelated copper products out there, and certainly better than copper sulfate at getting control of those tough types of algae. And tracking that even farther, we could see that the Captain XTR is actually getting more in. So we pulled the copper on the outside, that doesn't do much, and then we digest and saw how much actually got on the inside. And again, Captain XTR is driving significantly more copper into those cells, those tough nuisance mats, tough nuisance cells, and getting better control. So this image shows this correlation of that internalized copper or infused copper with control, and consistently, again, Captain XTR is getting more copper inside and more efficient control of these tough algae than the other formulations out there. Next up, we have another neat study here, and this study was on desorptions. So basically, we exposed the algae to a couple different copper algicide formulations, again, individually, including Captain XTR, and then we moved it to clean water, sort of mimicking these field exposures that may just be a band treatment or a benthic treatment or, you know, moving water treatment. where we have just a short exposure time. What's that product do after clean water comes in? Where's that copper go? And basically what we see is copper sulfate just releases a bunch more copper back into the water body. When that new water comes in, that copper desorbs come back off. Whereas with Captain XTR, we continue to penetrate, we continue to drive more copper into these cells, even with clean water out there. So very neat relationship and very effective at getting control, even with those shorter contact times, as we saw in the flowing water scenarios too. So these last few studies are actually very, very important. These last few studies, one's published, one's almost published, but these are on large field site applications. So we took a lot of this laboratory research or this scaled research and took it to some bigger field sites, tackling some of the largest nuisance lingbia infestations in the country with a Captain XTR treatment program. So this first image here is just a heat map. Basically red and orange is a lot more lingbia, and green and clear is a lot less lingbia, and we track this. These plots are from Lake Gaston on the North Carolina-Virginia border, and we're able to greatly decrease the biomass of lingbia out there over a two-season treatment program with Captain XTR. So neat to be able to track that. Here's another site we're monitoring and greatly decreased that biomass, took care of those big thick mats out there, really created a new balance in the ecosystem. So the next site was actually some large Alabama reservoirs. So these are very dendritic reservoirs, very shallow with some coves on it, and lingbia just got really thick out there, clogged things up, people couldn't use their boats, and they've been trying to manage lingbia out there for decades. So just, again, these thick mats and having a hard time getting control. But over the past couple seasons, we got them on the Captain XTR program and able to just bare ground some sites that they couldn't get a hold of for the past, again, just decades of trying with different types of products. So very efficient, very effective at controlling lingbia and decreasing those number of acres that need treated because the lingbia is not there anymore. So very, very powerful product to use even in these large-scale field sites. Very effective on many different types of algae, and again in all different manner of environmental conditions and field sites out there can be effective. What you can see here, here's a list of just some of those references, some of the research studies that I mentioned today. We can certainly provide these studies to you if you want to delve in and read more. I was just trying to give you those highlights, just the one or two key findings from all these scientific studies. But this video should just overall help you understand that this is a widely studied product, a highly used product, and can be used very efficiently and effectively to control even the toughest and most nuisance types of algae in a variety of field sites. So thank you for tuning in to this special research update on Captain XTR, and look forward to seeing you on future episodes of Algae Corner. We'll be right back.